Good morning, friends. The second topic for discussion today is protein synthesis or translation. An extensive detail of translation in my last video, which I am again uploading for you. Today I'll be just discussing the important question which has come in the university exam, that is, describe how protein is synthesized in the body. So if you're asked such a question, it means nothing but translation. You have to give all the steps of translation. Then you may be asked about what are the inhibitors of protein synthesis. You may be even asked what are their site of inhibition. Then a very important question which is repeatedly asked in the Kuhas examination is a note on the post-translational modification. As you can see, my video covers the answers for all of these. I have given you the details. What is translation? That pathway of protein biosynthesis. Where does it occur? It occurs on the ribosome. Minimum requirements for translation I have given you. What are the three different phases of eukaryotic translation, that is, initiation, elongation, and termination? Now, you have to, before we go to initiation, we know that the amino acids have to be activated. That activation of amino acids means the formation of the aminoacyl tRNA, which is a two-step reaction. The very important enzyme is the aminoacyl tRNA synthetase, which is highly specific for a particular amino acid. So it has its cognate tRNA. And during this process of formation of the aminoacyl tRNA, ATP is hydrolyzed. Now, where does this protein synthesis occur? It occurs on the ribosomes. So this is considered to be the factory where proteins are produced. And you find that there is a variation in the size in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Eukaryotes have two subunits, that is the 60 and 40S, which forms the largest subunit, which is the 80S subunit. Now, on this ribosome, we have specific RNAs, which are the ribosomal RNAs, and we have a large number of proteins. And the number of proteins which are there in the eukaryotes is much more than in the case of the prokaryotes. So, to help in the process of translation, we have the ribosomal RNA and also these ribosomal proteins, which are very important during the process of translation. So this gives us a difference between the prokaryotic ribosome. The size is different. One is 80S and the other is 70S. Now, what you have to remember is there are three sites for binding. You have the A site, the B site, and the exit site, as the east site, and this extends over both the subunits. So initiation can be divided into four stages, the details of which I'll be giving you in the slides, and I've also previously given you in my slides. You have the ribosomal dissociation, formation of the 43S pre-initiation complex, the formation of the 48S pre-initiation complex, and finally the reassociation of the two subunits to form the 80S initiation complex. I have given you in width figures. To remember very clearly is that each of these stages, the formation of the different complexes, the dissociation of the subunits, formation of the 43S pre-initiation complex, and the formation of the 40S initiation complex and of the 80S initiation complex have to be all clearly depicted in figures and clearly. So the figure is very important in the case of you will not get any marks. Then the second phase is the elongation phase. And as you know, it's a cyclic process, and the different steps of elongation is, one is the binding of the aminoacyl tRNA to the A site. You have the peptide bond formation for location. Now, as I told you, it contains two sites, the B site and the A site. The incoming aminoacyl tRNA always binds to the A site. Okay? And I have already told you a very important enzyme here is the peptidyl transferase enzyme, which is actually an RNA enzyme, which is mainly the 23S RNA. this is a cyclic process, the details you can make, see in the figure. Again, emphasizing that figure is very important, so it and learn. Termination occurs when a terminating codon appears at the A site. There is no amino acid or amino acid tRNA which recognizes this end. And so you find that what binds there is the releasing factor. And once the releasing factor binds, then the completely formed peptide chain will get released, and so also the tRNA is released. The ATS ribosome dissociates and is recycled. So I have explained all this in my previous, so I am not going into the details. Also, I have told you what are the inhibitors of protein synthesis. Antibiotics, I have grouped them, those which act on prokaryotes like tetracycline, chloroprenicol, and erythromycin. Then puromycin, they act on both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. The diphtheria toxin, which is also acting on both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Cyclohexamine in eukaryotes. And again, I told you very importantly, we have to also learn what is a post-translation body. Given the separate headings and the details under these first is second is the covalent alteration like phosphorylation, glycosylation, hydroxylation. Then we have other covalent modifications, then the protein degradations, and these are the different points that you have to remember in the case of translation. So figures are very important. I've also made sure that I've given you the important questions which have come in here.